Blue lights. What is it? What does it mean to us? Is it as bad as people make it seem? Time to find out. First off, humans everywhere are controlled by a special biological clock that controls your sleeping patterns. This is your circadian rhythm, and unlike your alarm clock, it doesn't have a snooze button. Recent news claims that this clock is affected by blue light. From Wired's magazine, an article entitled, "The Uncertain Science Behind Your Phone's Blue Light Dimmer," makes two bold statements about blue light. Now, whether or not they're true is something we'll later look into. The first claim is that blue light makes you more alert, but removing it may not actually help you fall asleep. Eliminating the blue light with the new feature Night Shift on the iPhone has not actually been proven to prevent or reduce the biological disruption caused by the blue light exposure at night. The second claim talks about the different cells present in our eyes. While we all heard of rods and cones and how they control our perception of color, the article claims that a third type of photoreceptors called photosensitive retinal ganglion cells are primarily responsible for circadian rhythms and processing blue light, even without your other rods and cones. On the other hand, we have a journal article entitled "Analysis of Circadian Properties and Healthy Levels of Blue Light from Smartphones at Night" by OAL. This article mentions the CIL, circadian illuminance levels for smartphone displays, and can drastically decrease melatonin secretion, which will affect your circadian rhythm and health. Protecting yourself from the blue light does not mean to turn off your smartphone, but to use well-designed SPDs, spectral power distribution, and a proper intensity of the smartphone display. While the news article claims that night shift is useless for getting good sleep, the journal article says otherwise. The journal says that changing the colors and the intensities from the displays decreases the blue light effect on our circadian rhythm. A simple edit by the author can change the validity of the news article drastically. While it is true that circadian rhythm is mostly controlled by photosensitive retinal ganglion cells, our rods and cone cells are mostly responsible for vision. The ganglion cells are right behind them and they detect the brightness of our surroundings. This way they send all the information to the optic nerve and from there to our brain, the human master clock. In the brain, a specific region called the hypothalamus is responsible in connecting your nervous system to your endocrine system. Our biological clock is mostly controlled by a group of nerve cells within the hypothalamus called suprachiasmatic nuclei, SCN for short. SCN is connected to our optic nerve, which allows us to respond to light or dark. In the morning, when natural light hits our eyes, it activates a ganglion cell to send messages via the optic nerve to our brain. As a result of this, the SCN sends signals to our endocrine system to raise our body temperature, heartbeat, blood pressure, and delay the release of our sleep hormone known as melatonin. Research has found as blue light hits our eyes in the morning, our memory, focus, alertness, concentration, and many of our other physiological behaviors also sharpen. As a result of this, we are able to do a lot of great activities, from studying, ballet dancing, to even mountain climbing. At the end of the day, when the ganglion cells detect low brightness light, SCN sends signals to lower our physiological behaviors. For instance, our body temperature falls, we feel tired, and our sleep hormones melatonin starts kicking off. Blue lights before bedtime affect our circadian rhythm by suppressing the secretion of melatonin, which results in a shorter sleep, and a shorter sleep has been associated with a high risk of depression, diabetes, and cardiovascular difficulties, which is why blue light should be avoided. What are some simple steps to help prevent the potential effects of blue lights? Well, first, we can avoid looking at screens such as laptops and phones about 2 to 3 hours before bedtime. In addition, we can also turn off all house lights that emit blue light 2 to 3 hours before bedtime as well. As simple as these steps are, they may not be practical for everyone. Some alternatives to blue light include using dim red lights as night lights, and using the warm light setting on Philips Hue light bulbs at night. There are also ways to reduce blue light's adverse effects. First, you can coat the inside of fluorescent LED bulbs to filter out some blue light, and if your work requires night shifts, wearing blue blocking glasses might help reduce blue light too. Blue light at night affects us all sleeping tight, so make sure you do not take this topic light.